Let me take you back to November 6th, 1814, a small village in the south of Belgium called Dinant. That day, God decided that guitar players also needed heroes. So, Adolf Sax was born. He became known as the inventor of the saxophone, an instrument widely acknowledged as the most superior of all musical instruments, and till this day, still banned by the Vatican. Adolf's life was quite dramatic. As a child, he almost drowned, fell down the stairs and cracked his skull. He contracted measles and was in a coma for 9 days. He mistakenly drank a cup of vitriol, thinking it was milk. People started calling him Le Petit Revenant, the little ghost. But the little ghost always managed to survive. Adolf would invent the saxophone in 1841 in Brussels. Very soon hereafter, Adolf moved to Paris, which then was the cultural center of Europe. He continued fine-tuning his invention and managed to get a patent for his saxophone family in 1846. Adolf met with fierce opposition. The standard of his work was so high that he made his competitors look like amateurs. And they did not like that. They bribed his staff, torched his workplace, and even tried to assassinate him on several occasions. He went bankrupt 3 times, mostly due to all legal battles with his competitors. But Adolf was a fighter. It was in his nature to do so. He even survived cancer. The little ghost died on February 7th, 1894, against all odds of old age, and became almost 80. Sadly, he never saw the big breakthrough of his most famous invention, the saxophone. His son, Edward Sax, picked up the family tradition, but he lacked the brilliance of his father. The patent for the saxophone then had long expired, allowing other manufacturers to also make saxophones, and many did. There wasn't much left for Edward, and in the end, he asked upcoming star Henri Selmer to produce his saxophones. In 1929, Selmer took over Edward's almost bankrupt business, and Selmer, they did a great job. They basically standardized the saxophone, and today, Selmer is one of the most respected names in saxophone land. Henri Selmer managed to turn his business into a success story. Quite recently, in 2018, Selmer sold 80% of their shares to a big private equity group, now becoming the most powerful saxophone manufacturer in the world. But what happened to the name Adolf Sax? Well, Selmer discontinued making Adolf Sax saxophones around 1932 and started focusing on their own brand. The name Adolf Sax disappeared until the name resurfaced 80 years later. In 2012, a young Belgian acquired the legal rights to the name Adolf Sax & Company and announced his plans to bring the production of the saxophone back to the country that gave birth to both the inventor and the invention of the saxophone. My name is Carl, I am the proud owner of Adolf Sax & Company, I approve of this message.